Welcome to another beekeeping session. We've had really cold weather yet again here in the deep south. Below freezing into the 20s, and so I've been at home. I don't open my hives when it's cold. I don't open my hives if it's 50 and gonna be 20, unless I absolutely have to. So I've been stuck at home. Just before I left the yard the other day, though, I had a queen show up with a very tiny retinue. I believe she came out of some sort of small hive, whether it was mine or somebody else's in the area or a wild one, and I didn't want to just leave her. When you leave a queen, well, one, I didn't want to just leave her in another hive and hope that that hive didn't kill her. So she had this retinue. I went ahead and I caged her. And in this roller cage, I have queen candy and I have worker bees with her. If I put her in a queen right hive, because it's spring and, you know, we don't have virgin hives, we don't have queenless hives, I couldn't find where she came from, I could have ended up inadvertently killing her. That's because they wouldn't feed her, even with some bees in there, that still, if it got cold like it did, the cluster would have clustered way down below, and these girls would have never been able to keep her warm. So I caged her and I put her in my car. Let's see. So how long can a queen stay in a cage? So this queen is mated. I can't imagine that she's not, but she's not marked, so I don't know where she came from or why. When I put her in, I ship queens. I put anywhere from 4 to 8 workers. I have had queens get stuck in the mail, and they have made it well over a week. So let me tell you, as beginner beekeepers or seasoned beekeepers that just don't understand how it is that they work, the workers are who keeps that queen alive. Will the queen feed herself? Yes. There are some people that will tell you no, but she will feed herself a little bit. That's what she does when she first emerges. She feeds herself. When she's in the shipping cage and she has queen candy, there is no water. So when I ship a queen, I say to anyone that's getting the queen is to give her a drop of water, and I will show you how to do that. But those workers are what's going to keep her alive. This is the cup of water, and I have filtered water in the house. I suggest, you know, if you have to use tap water and you know it's fairly clean tap water, go ahead. You don't have to go too crazy. Maybe distilled water might be a little better. If your municipality uses a lot of chlorine, you kind of should be careful. So when you get your queen, or you bring home your queen, they're in their little roller cage. A lot of times you can see or feel their little feet on the outside. That's their feet down there. That's so cute. And what you want to do is you can just dip your finger and you get a little bit of water. So there's your water. That's all they need, because bees go through a ton of water in the hive. So, oops. Just touch it to the top. And you can see the little dot of water up there. If they're thirsty, you can actually feel them lick your finger. You don't need to get them wet. And they will drink it. There they go. they begin to drink the water, and that's all it is. If you feel better using a Q-tip or whatever, go ahead and do that. But it is a drop of water that they can get to. You can receive a queen in the mail, or if you picked her up in your yard, put her in a cage, and put her in with 4 to 8 or more. Every time there's a worker in there, that's an extra length of time that she can stay in that cage. It is not ideal. That's not what I'm saying. It's a matter of how are we going to keep this queen till we can get her on frames of her own. So, I've had her in this cage in my house trying to wait out this weather for over a week. It's too cold. There's not enough going on to grab an extra frame of brood and bees. She's going to have to wait this out. And I can't put her anywhere because the queens that are in the hive would make sure that she is just not taken care of. But the bees in here will say, yeah, they're going to feed her. So, if you have a queen and she's shipped like this and you can't get out to your hive, every time a bee dies in there, you have to try to get them out. If the workers die, that's your time limit. The queen cannot survive by herself, both with warmth and by feeding. Bees tend to go up, if you touch it up. That's the queen candy. Those are the bees. Those are the bees. You want to keep them out of the sun. You want to keep them out of too much heat. You want to keep them out of too much cold. Heat will kill them faster. In my house, I have a battery box, and I just put her in so that she can be in the shade. So, if you find a queen and you don't know what to do with her, put her in a cage and figure it out. You have about a week, maybe more, depending on how good you are at caring for your bee and how many workers you can manage to put in the cage. It's something we do. It's a tool in your box, and don't be afraid to do it. If she dies in your care, it doesn't really matter, because if you didn't try, she'd be dead anyway. So, to go over it one more time, if you have a queen in a cage, whether you put her there or you got her mailed to you, the workers are what will keep her alive. If they start to die, one, try to remove them. If you're too afraid, don't worry about it. Get her into a hive. The workers will keep her alive. She can live almost 2 weeks like this. Not ideally, never saying ideally, but this will hold her till you can get her into a hive. Or make a queenless nuke and get her going again. I hope you found that informative and useful, and if you did, click subscribe, hit the bell, tell your friends, share this video, and until later, peace, bruh.
Cara tawa jumawa hingga pinggir angkuhan. Ciptakan kepalsuan. Duduk di singgah sana ditutupi ketidakpedulian. Seakan ku selamat dah hati atau tak ada lagi daun delinga ini. Kemana engkau kini tegakkan badan kepalkan tangan satukan doa bukalah mata lihat. Lai sengat tangis selalu menggebar di bumi Palestina.
Di bumi itu memecah luka namun dunia membungkam. Layaknya sungai yang kelam hitam di sang pun membisu. Sunyi-sunyi layaknya nyanyian tak ada kata tanpa hati.